The word Rabb is really important for several reasons. One of them is it's the first name Allah used to introduce himself to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is also the first name Allah used for himself before he even used Allah when he introduced himself to Musa alayhi salam. When Allah introduced himself to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said Iqra bismi rabbik. Rabb. The word Allah did not occur in the passage. Rabb did. Musa alayhi salam goes up on the mountain. Ya Musa, inni ana rabbuk fakhla'na alayk. Innaka bilwadi al-muqaddasi tuwa. Wa ana akhtartuka fastami' lima yuha innani ana Allah. Allah came later, Rabb came first. Rabb. So the word Rabb is the introduction Allah wants us to have. Even in the Fatiha, after Allah tells us about himself as Allah, the first thing he wants us to know of all his names and attributes is what? Alhamdulillahi Rabb. And actually I told you, this sequence of the Quran is remarkable. Allah said, Allah mentioned him, his lafz al-jalala first, Allah. Then he said Rabbul Alameen. Look at the end of Quran. Surah al-Ikhlas is Allah. Qul huwa Allah. Allah. And then two surahs about Rabb. Qul a'udhu bi Rabbil falaq, Rabbil nas. Just like Fatiha, the first ayah is what? Allah first, Rabb second. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. So you have Surah al-Ikhlas about Allah, and the word Allah does not occur in falaq or in nas, but the word Rabb does. So there's the same progression. That is